What's going on, everybody? In today's video, I'm going to show you I took a trip down to Belhaven, North Carolina. I went down there for 2 days. I was going down there to target speckled trout, flounder, and drum. I'd heard that the speckled trout were biting pretty good around Belhaven, and also being that flounder season's in North Carolina, I figured I'd try to go down there and capitalize on that. However, when I got down there, I realized I was having some engine trouble with my big engine, and I wasn't able to use it, so I was just limited to my trolling motor. Luckily, the trout that were biting at the bridge in Belhaven, which is not very far from the boat ramp, and I was able to just use my trolling motor to get out there. I had a lot of success on a popping cork rig, and I'll show you right here. I was using this rig right here. I got the popping cork, and then I got about a 3 foot leader. I was in about 10 foot of water catching those fish, so I think that extra length on that leader helped. I was using a Berkeley Gulp ripple mullet and a 4-inch with a white with a chartreuse tail. This is a Z-Man bait, similar to what I was throwing. The fish actually ate me out of those ripple mullets. But I throw that popping cork on this Lose inshore speed stick. It's 7 foot 11 inches, heavy action, and I've got a Shimano Stratic 4000 reel on it. Now, this is a rod and reel that I would traditionally use to catch like big striper freshwater, or try to catch some big redfish saltwater, like 20, 30, 40 pound redfish. So it's a real heavy rod for trout fishing, but throwing a popping cork on a real light rod, like what I traditionally use, such as like a 2000 size reel on a medium light action rod, I just can't get a lot of distance with the popping cork. The action of the rod just doesn't allow me to cast it. So I find that using a heavier action rod allows me to get some distance out of that popping cork. And you don't really need the sensitivity because you're not really feeling the bite. The popping cork's doing all the work. It seemed like the best luck I was having was just casting the cork out there and letting it drift with the current. I wasn't actually popping the cork. I was just sitting it out there, and a fish would swim along and take it pretty good. I also had a little bit of luck on a Rapala Shadow Wrap Deep jerkbait. I just recently found these and figured out that they work real good for speckled trout. I think they're kind of designed to be a bass fishing lure. And that white color is what I had the most luck on. And that's a real good speckled trout bait. I've only used them maybe 2 or 3 times for speckled trout, and every time I've been able to catch at least a fish on one. So those work really well. It wasn't the greatest action, but I was able to scrape out a limit. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you do, hit that thumbs up button, leave me a comment, and subscribe. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.